Welcome to part 5 of my 3D screencasting series. In today's episode, we're going to have some serious fun, and I mean serious. Today, we're going to learn how to animate our window in 3D space. Aw, yeah, that's what we've been waiting to do. So let's not waste any more time and get started.
The first thing I want to do is actually create these layers as 3D layers. So I'll toggle on the 3D layer functionality. And then I'm going to create a light. So we'll come up to the layer, new. We'll come over to light. And we'll choose spot as the name. Notice the light type is spot. And I've got a few settings in here which you can mimic if you want. We'll say OK. And I'm just going to move this light around real quickly and sort of try and get maybe a good stab at how I want the light set up. Move it back a little bit. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a camera. So we'll go ahead and come to the layer menu. We'll come to new. We'll come down to camera. We'll give it the name camera. And we'll make sure we choose the widest preset, which is 15 millimeters. We'll say okay. Now I'm going to switch over to my unified camera tool. So I'll click on that. And we're just going to adjust the perspective of this scene here. So we'll maybe give a little bit of perspective. We'll maybe pull back a little bit more. Move it over. Just kind of mess around with this till you're happy with it. Okay, so we've got this really nice perspective set up. Now it's time to do some animation of just this window. So we're going to come over into the scene maybe to about, I don't know, minute 11 or so. And we're going to go ahead and twizzle down the window's transform properties and go ahead and create some keyframes here. So for anchor point, position, scale, and orientation, we'll create keyframes. We'll move the playhead over 5 frames. And we'll animate this window out. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to actually bring the anchor point out, create some distance between this control panel and the desktop, so there's some depth between the two. And we'll come down to the orientation, and we'll change this orientation to maybe, let's try 6. And you can notice that control panel disappears behind the plane of the desktop, so we need to bring it forward. So we'll grab the position, and we'll bring it forward. I'm going to switch to my mouse tool here. I'm just kind of drag and reposition this control panel, and maybe we'll scale it up a little bit too. Okay, so this is real cool. I'm going to zoom in on the timeline here, and we're going to scrub back and forth a little bit, and you can see we've got this nice little animation where this guy pops out from that desktop.
Lights, camera, action! I've been waiting a long time to say that, and it seemed appropriate since we finally got things moving in 3D space. But we're not done. There's one more step, one more episode, and then we're going to do the final subtle tweaks that really help us sell this whole thing. So we'll be applying some motion blur and easing on the animation front, and we're going to learn how to cast shadows with our 3D objects. You won't want to miss it. I'll see you then.